Okay, thank you, Josh. So I will start. If anybody here doesn't know me yet, my name is Gadi Shiftan. I'm Haifa CRF Marketing Manager. And today's with me, I will present Gad Shachar. It will be the second half of the presentation. And today is Haifa Academy lesson, or let's say chapter, will be on CoteN Dual. It's an innovative controlled release fertilizer, and we will explain shortly what it is. So with regards to the presentation content, we will talk first about nutrient use efficiency, what is it, and then obviously the mechanism of nitrogen losses. We will talk about inhibitors, and then CoteN Dual, it's a combined CRF solution. We will then examine the our R&D efforts with inhibitors, and eventually address the regulatory and environmental requirements on the subject of nitrogen in the agriculture. So when we're talking about the nutrient use efficiency or any efficiency, you know, we all know this kind of a scale that we see in home appliance or in or the motor car industry. And then, you know, you can place based on the specific efficiency of a product or a solution where it is on this gauge. And I think by the end of the presentation or the webinar today, most of you will place the product we are talking about somewhere here on the top green, and you will come to understand why. So when we're talking about nutrient use efficiency, there's many aspects and many things that can influence soil, the water, the fertilization method. It all come down to the nutrient use efficiency, and it will directly influence on the productivity, sustainability, and so on. And in this slide, I think I will try to deeper explain. So basically, it's nutrient use efficiency, of course, is it's how much we are the plant is uptake out of the supply, and what is the utilization for biomass for yield eventually. And you know that for instance, if we're looking on irrigation type, then sprinkler are more effective than flooding. But in terms of nutrient use efficiency, we will get nice result, I would say, with sprinklers. But with irrigation such as drip irrigation, you will get much higher nutrient use efficiency. And of course, it goes similarly to flood irrigation, which is less effective in terms of nutrient use efficiency. Now, where we don't have irrigation at all, such as some of the arable crops, depending where and what season, of course, but then the efficiency of the product is even of nutrient use efficiency, it's much, much lower. And on this presentation, we will focus mainly on this part, and we will explain how with the different nutrient solution, innovative solution by Haifa, we can get to much higher nutrient use efficiency. The mechanism of nitrogen losses, we will start with this simple slide. We have mainly, when we're talking about herbal crops, it's mainly nitrogen. This is the main drive. And nitrogen can almost immediately volatilize as ammonia, or later on leached as nitrate. Some of it might run off by erosion, by strong event of rain. And it all leads us to poor nutrient use efficiency, which means losses, and definitely contamination. Contamination of groundwater, if it's a nitrate, and contamination of the atmosphere, if we're having volatilization of nitrate gases, nitrogen gases, I'm sorry. Now, this slide is a little bit complicated, but we all know it. This is part of the nitrogen cycle, and I want to touch this important part of today's webinar. So if we start with the urea fertilizer in the soil now, or on top of the soil, we will quite fast, we will find the urea's enzyme that will transform the via hydrolysis, the urea into ammonium and also ammonia. So if we are sitting on the top of the soil, ammonia will are due to volatilize as gas, okay? And I want to say a few more words about ammonium. Ammonium, it's positively charged, and so it will attach to the soil particles, to the clay, which is negatively charged, and by that will be available for some time for the roots to for take up, because plant roots are the form of nitrogen that is available is either ammonium or nitrate. We will come to nitrate right away. So from ammonium, by nitrification, we can go to nitrate and then nitrate and then nitrate. And the nitrate is negatively charged, and so it due to leach. Where to? All the way to groundwater, most likely. And this is why it's considered a serious contamination. It's not just too much fertilizer that, okay, we gave a little bit more, nothing will happen. No, something can happen, and it's an environmental impact. Of course, there's more to this cycle that nitrate can change into nitrogen oxide via the nitrification. But this stage, let's say that if it's in the soil, it's less crucial, then it's on top of the soil, and then we have these nitrogen gases volatilization. Now, I will talk now a little bit about the Haifa CoteN mix. Haifa CoteN mix is our solution for arable crops, Haifa solution. We're talking CoteN is basically Haifa multi-coat technology on urea. Okay, so we're talking about nitrogen fertilizer, very effective with release and with nutrient use efficiency. We will translate it into result also a little bit later. But as mentioned before, it's based on Haifa polymer coating technology. It releases nutrients to the soil in a gradual manner, and the main effect is temperature, and by that, it's really according to the plant nutrients, the release rate. It's preventing the nutrient volatilization and leaching, and so it's must improved nutrient use efficiency and allowed even a lower application rates. If we are to zoom in into CoteN mix blend, then part of it is fully coated CoteN. Again, multi-coat technology on urea. Okay, this is the brown part. Some of it will be white with just granular urea. And this is a blend we do especially for arable crops. It's ideal for such a crop because of the high nutrient requirement. So we have ready-made available nitrogen for, let's say, for corn, that will need a very high demand at the beginning of the crop cycle. It's that's why it's very much suitable for arable crops. And you can understand the impact of CoteN mix, just like let's look on the availability. So if I'm using traditional fertilizers such as urea, then I have here an application, the availability drops, and then we have another application, the availability drops, and so on. And with multi-coat technology, with CoteN mix, we can have single application for the whole crop cycle. It sounds almost unbelievable for those who doesn't know it, but it is, in fact, we will see results soon. So if I'm taking the enhanced efficiency product, such as CRF or water soluble, and with enhanced application method as a nutrigation or foliar application, we will increase nutrient use efficiency. We will reduce the environmental impact of intensive farming. And here on this trial, we looked on CoteN. Okay, in the soil, this was performed in Aronson Center in Israel. And then we applied also urea on top as a top dress, and urea via fertigation. So the orange is the urea on the top dress, and you can see that there's a lot of leaching quite fast. And the urea with the fertigation was much more effective in that way, leaching. And the CoteN mix hardly leached at all. So you can see the picture, and I have an even stronger picture to show in a minute. But the impact, it's stronger even, the impact of more and more fertilizer that is not with low efficiency, because when we're applying conventional nitrogen fertilizer, some of it will be volatilized as ammonia, we explain how. Some will be leaching as nitrate, we explained exactly how. It will cause contamination to groundwater and to the atmosphere. But because of these losses, we have to apply again. And we will experience the same losses again, and we might have to apply even one more time. Opposed to CoteN mix, where we're applying a single application. So with CoteN mix, with single application, we applied less nitrogen. This result we achieved from different parts of the world, especially from Europe. So you can see in rice, in wheat, in corn. So in wheat, we had 50% less nitrogen with 30% more grains. This is nutrient use efficiency. And it achieved only with such an innovative product like CoteN Mix. With corn, we see similar picture, 45% less nitrogen and 21% more in yield. Okay, so we have a strong established proof for the way it works. And if it's not enough, I have this, this is a fresh graph from here, from Israel, from a trial we did. It was a multi-cot agri, this is the CRF actually, under sprinkler, which is less effective as we've seen before, but we compared it to liquid fertilizer with drip irrigation. And what we have here is measurement in depth of 20 centimeters. So it's below the root zone. Remember that garlic have a very shallow root system. So 20 centimeters, it's below the root zone. And we see that we had a very strong high EC of electrical conductivity, 20 centimeters inside, and compared to multi-cot agri, again, multi-cot technology, almost no change of EC, very, very practical. And with the nitrate, it's the same picture. So we have a very high nitrate running through the system. And again, with at 20 centimeters depth, it will probably continue to leach with time all the way to the groundwater. So this is the picture. This is the classic farming as we know it, compared to multi-cot agri solution, hardly any leaching. And yes, we have to talk about yield. In this trial, we said before for the garlic, we obtained also 22% better, higher yield. Okay, so this is nutrient use efficiency. Nobody can deny. Now let's talk about nitrogen inhibitor. That's why we are here after all. So we talked a little bit before about the process of urea transforming into ammonium or ammonium and ammonia. There's a balance here. It's mostly happens when we apply urea on top dress. And we have the solution in terms of inhibitor is the NBPT. This is a urease inhibitor. It's blocking the active site of the enzyme. And by that, preventing the urea to transform into ammonium, ammonia, and the cycle. And the main idea is to have urea, to keep it as urea until when? Until we have irrigation or until there's a rain that solubilize urea into the soil, and then it can go to the process, hopefully transforming into ammonium, and then will be attached to the soil particle and will be available for the plant. So this is the NBPT, urease inhibitor. The second stage, I would say, of inhibitors, it's DMPP. In this case, it's a nitrification inhibitor, and it's working on the stage between ammonium and nitrate. Okay, so keeping ammonium at ammonium form, which means more available for the plant at the because it can be attached to the soil particles, and by that also eliminating the nitrate leaching. And I think I said before, we all know it, but just to make sure that we all are on the same page, plant can take ammonium and nitrates and into as a nitrogen fertilizer. So both of them are available for the plant, but again, the leaching is more critical from the nitrate. Okay, so this is the nitrification inhibitor. And now the CoteN Dual, it's a combined CRF solution. We have polymer-coated urea, multi-coat technology, it's actually the CoteN. This is the part. And the dual is dual technologies, and I will come to explain. The first technology, it's a controlled release fertilizer technology I just explained before. And the second technology is what we've seen in the last two slides. It's non-coated nitrogen, but it's treated nitrogen with inhibitors. Okay, so it's improving nutrient use efficiency. And we will see some trials that Gad will present us a little bit later. It's reducing leaching and emission, and it's economically suitable. And it's very important to explain it also compliance with environmental regulation in some places around the world, such as in Germany, that you need to apply inhibitors on your urea when you're applying. But if we zoom, again, we have to zoom a little bit in because this is the practical part is very important. I explained the difference between ureas and the nitrification inhibitor. But when we're applying the CoteN Dual, we have to know at the end of the day, if we're going to apply it as top dress, if it's in top dress, we will need the ureas inhibitor. If we apply it in the soil, when preparing the soil or when seeding, for instance, we will need the nitrification inhibitor. Okay, so it's very important that one that want to use this kind of product will know what will be the end application method. It's very important. Otherwise, it's not not effective. So the CoteN Dual, this is a data sheet of a product we have in France. In this case, we're talking about the ureas inhibitor. We have two inhibitors there, the NBPT and NPPT. It's a combined mix. And basically, this is the product of CoteN Dual. We can have more of this type. We have in our blender, SED, in France now, in South France. We have available this product to apply on such as a CoteN Dual mixes. But we have to remember there's a little bit of problem with the shelf life of this product. So I suggest not to bring these blends from France to your territories, but to apply it locally, the local blender. Most of the blenders today, the agricultural blenders will have this or other solution for inhibitors. We don't have strong feelings to specific inhibitor, but we know it. They are all working quite well on the small scale of solution they give. And it's important to understand this is part of the solution as far as we can see it, not the solution. The solution is CoteN mix, but if we want to extend the solution for dual technologies, CoteN Dual is the answer. And from here, I'm transforming to Gad Shachar. Gadi?
Yeah. Thank you, Gadi. I just will share my presentation. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let me make sure.
Gadi, change the display mode setting.
Again?
At the top. No, at the top. Go to display setting. Yeah.
No, but I think not with the right presentation. Stop share. Okay.
Okay, hello everyone. I will continue from here referring to the process of development and the research around the CoteN Dual, mentioned by Gadi. And actually, as a company that very much involved in controlled release fertilizer up till a few years ago, only on the controlled release fertilizer, for us it was the first stage. An important stage was to understand the nature of the inhibitors. And then we start, in order to do it, so we start a cooperation with the CoteN Institute in Haifa, in Israel, testing the ureas inhibitor NBPT to study and also understand better the effectiveness of this inhibitor. This was done in the CoteN. In the following year, we extend the trial to continue the CoteN, but at the same time, we start with trials also in the Aronson Farm, the R&D and Innovation Center of Haifa in Israel. Also in Glendlab, it's a private agricultural research institute in northern part of Italy, and also some open tech field trials, one was conducted in France. And this was followed in the next year, 2018 and 19. by the end of 2019-20, we start already the semi-commercial trials And actually today we are able and ready to provide the CoteN, as Gadi mentioned, on a local basis. From here, I will refer for several trials that we did just to demonstrate the effectiveness of the CoteN Dual. This trial was done in the Haifa Research Center in Atlit. And here it was done with a basil plant. And what here we can see, see the system of the trial in the facility. Actually, we have a basil growing inside the sleeves, and those sleeves were covered with plastic sheets in order to be able to capture the gas emissions from the applications of the different products. In order to detect the gas emission, we use what we call an infrared beam that vibrates the molecules of the different substance. In our case, we refer and the interest was in the ammonia and the nitrous oxide. And here we can see how the beam is worked. Actually, it's bombing the beam and then the detector and mirror, it's taking back the beam back to the detector, and in this way we are getting the measurement of those two substances. In this trial, we have tested the three treatments or fertilization program, and we are referring first to the CRF 4 months release. This CRF was applied once after the transplanting. Urea treated with an urea inhibitor and untreated urea. And the trial was conducted along about 3 months, and we have in total 4 cutting or harvest. And after each harvest, before we carried out an application of N, actually we divided to 3 applications. The total N was applied, was divided to 3. And each time after the cutting, we apply again the treated urea and the urea untreated. And here we can see clearly this situation was captured on after the third cutting and before the first the last growing cycle of the basil. And here we can see clearly that a big amount of losses was subject to losses of nitrogen was in the beginning of the first two days after the application. And again, we can see here that the big losses was in gram of N per hour per hectare. Of the urea was the biggest one by far compared to the urea treated with ureas and the CoteN and the multi-coat agri. Actually, it was applied in one single application in the beginning of the transplanting. Besides the emission, also evaluate the yield. And here we can see the fresh yield per container in kilograms. And here we have the 4 cutting that we did. And again, you can see here clearly the controlled fertilizer has the best performance. Followed by the urea inhibitor treated urea and by the regular urea untreated one. In parallel, in the same year, we did a field trial in France. This was done in a cone, and in this trial, actually, we have tested the CoteN Dual in comparison with what we call the CoteN Mix that was mentioned. As Gadi mentioned, in the CoteN mix, we have a portion of nitrogen that's uncoated. And the idea is to treat this portion by the res inhibitor and to see how we can improve the nitrogen use efficiency in this case compared to the one that the product that has a portion that's untreated. And here again, we can see a clear result. You can see if we are going directly to the yield, in this case, you can see that was a 9% increase in the yield per hectare. And again, one important thing that I've not mentioned, you can see here that in the case of the qualitative of CoteN Dual, we applied only 230 kg compared to 260, it's about 11% less. But when we are coming to the yield with less nitrogen, we are getting a higher yield. Then it's clear, demonstrate the higher yield efficiency of the nitrogen. On 2018, we did a trial in Glendale that I mentioned before, and here actually it was again on corn. This trial, it was based or consists of the farmer practice in southern part of France. And as you know, there we have some indication of the usage of amount of nitrogen per hectare. And then what we actually compare is the CoteN Dual in top dressing and four leaves instead of four leaves, heated with a rare inhibitor in comparison with the farmer practice that is consist of a base dressing application of DAP and two top dressing of untreated urea, one in four leaves and the second one in eight leaves. What we can see here that in case of the farmer practice, all the nitrogen are untreated. In our case, 35% was in coated portion in this product, in the CoteN Dual. 20% of the nitrogen is coming from DAP, and here it was treated with a detection inhibitor. And 45% of the nitrogen, it was urea, was treated with the urea inhibitor. Here we can, again, we target the 185 kg. This is more or less the limit of the what the farmer are allowed to use in France, compared to 217 kilo, it is 15% less. And here we can see clear results. Again, we can see that CoteN Dual is similar or even with higher yield compared to the farmer practice. But we need to give an attention here that here we are referring to two top dressing applications. And here in the case of CoteN Dual, only to one application in four leaves. And this also because in France, there is the regulation on the application of big amount of nitrogen as a base dressing. Then even the top, then there is no, we need to make this kind of top dressing because of this limitation. And we can see here again, in revenue, it's a slight higher. And when we are coming to the what we call the nitrogen use efficiency index, we can see a clear higher value in the case of the CoteN Dual compared to the farmer practice. And if we are summarizing higher nitrogen use efficiency with less nitrogen, just to explain a bit about this nitrogen use efficiency index, what actually we are doing is we are taking the uptake, the total uptake in of all parts of the plant, talking about the fresh biomass and the grain, and comparing it to the applied fertilizer. Actually, we are dividing this amount by this amount, and we can see how much uptake we have for each kg of fertilizer that was applied. And we can see here, it's clearly higher in the case of CoteN Dual. On the year later, in 2019, the same place in Lebla, we did something similar, but the difference was that in this year, we are using what CoteN Dual based on the nitrification inhibitor. Then the urea and the DAP was treated only with DMPP, but in this case, the fertilizer was incorporated into the soil at the sowing time. And in this CoteN Dual, we had 40% urea coated, 20% nitrogen coming from DAP treated with DMPP, And also the urea that was incorporated into the soil was treated with DMPP. Again, only 135 kg per hectare with 15% reduction in N. And here again, it's a clear results. We can see that the CoteN Dual, here in this case with DMPP, only in one single application in best dressing with less 15% less of nitrogen, the performance was quite similar and even higher than the farmer practice, even if the revenue slightly higher. And again, the nitrogen use index, again, it's much higher in this treatment compared to the farmer practice. Again, only with a single application that is meaning a lot of labor saving and headache for the farmer. Then if we are summarizing then those trials, then we have higher nitrogen use efficiency, we have less ammonia and nitrous oxide emissions, labor saving, and better and higher yield. As we all aware of in the recent year, the regulation and the concerns for the environmental are coming more and more, are increasing, and it's we need to address those regulations and constraints that we are facing. I just want to share a few regulations that we have a short summary. The first, I mentioned before, limitation on an application rate, its restriction on the best dressing application and on the total amount, for instance, in France and in more countries. Another regulation, it's reduction of the gas emission in greenhouse gas emissions, or what also associated with the carbon footprint that I will refer to it shortly. And this is coming from a regulation from 2016 related to the emissions of those those substance. On practical side, it was mentioned by Gadi also, is that the farmer actually today, since last year, are not allowed to use what we call the white urea, untreated urea in Germany, unless they are incorporated into the soil or irrigating immediately afterwards. Otherwise, it should be incorporated into the soil. Another regulation that is is asked for more yield is the reduction of the NO3 leaching, the nitrate leaching into the underground soil. And here we can see the regulation that refer to this. And this again, in CoteN Dual, when part of the big part of the nitrogen is coated, then we are avoiding this kind of leaching almost completely. Then, as I mentioned before, the carbon footprint that I mentioned before, then what is actually the carbon footprint? Then we are referring to the impact of all kinds of activity have on the amount of carbon dioxide that is produced globally. This include all the emissions and from burning of fuels in manufacturing, heating, transportation, as well as in the production of electricity. Although we are trying to have what we call the clean energy, still big part of energy in the world is electricity is produced by burning fossil fuel. And here we're going to refer to also, beside to the carbon dioxide, there are more gases that are referred as greenhouse gas emission. And those are the methane, the nitrate that is very much associated with the activity of the livestock in the agriculture, nitrous oxide that is very much associated with fertilization. And this is what actually the DMPP, the nitrification inhibitor, is supposed to mitigate. And also a chloro and fluorocarbons gases. Just to understand the big, I don't know, a problem that we have with the nitrous oxide is, you can see here that this substance or gas have three times more powerful, it's more powerful in warming potential than compared to the carbon dioxide. And for this reason, even when they are, we are referring to an absolute amount is much less than the carbon dioxide, because of the strength of the warming potential of it, it is today considered as the third, in the third place among those greenhouse gas emissions, following the carbon dioxide and the methane. Then how the carbon footprint actually is expressed, the unit we are using for it is a kilogram of carbon dioxide equivalent per a kilogram of product that are produced, or activity or service that we are producing. Each such activity can have a carbon footprint. And here we can have, we can see an example calculating the footprint of the production of ammonium nitrate, in this case, 1 kg of nitrate from ammonium nitrate. And here we see, we are referring only to the production process. You can see here from raw material, it was nothing, but from energy, from production, we have nitrous oxide emissions and methane from the production, CO2. And in total, it summarized to about 3.5 kg of carbon dioxide for 1 kg from, it's about for 3 kg of ammonium nitrate. Here in this slide, we can refer to more activities that can cause this kind of footprint or contribution to the gas emission. And here, beside to the production, we are also referring to transportation and cultivation. And here we can see two products, urea and ammonium sulfate. And urea, in first, we can see the urea untreated. Urea that is treated with urea as inhibitor. But here we can see that when we are referring to a nitrous oxide, this here we are, have not had a big benefit of this application. But when this urea that with time is entered and into the soil and treated with the resin inhibitor and the nitrification inhibitor, we can see that the emission or the footprint from the cultivation is going down dramatically. We can see also the product that the nitrogen is coming, the form is in ammonium and not in urea form, it's from initially has less carbon footprint, for instance, ammonium sulfate, because all the nitrogen is in ammonium form. But when this kind of product is treated, this ammonium is treated with nitrification inhibitor, we can see a significant reduction in the emission of the nitrous oxide from the stage of the cultivation activity. Now, as we know in life, each challenge or difficulty that we are facing is also give us some of the opportunities. And here I'd like to refer to the farmer actually can generate money from this, from obeying this regulation. And here we are referring to the carbon credit. And this can be, we can gain from a precise and management that was mentioned, and CoteN Dual can be a good player, an important player in this and doing it, as was showed before. Now, these carbon credits that a farmer can generate it could be sold to a large company. We can refer mainly to those of producing electricity that has a lot of emissions from their plants. And we are estimating that the income for per hectare can range between 3 to 13 US dollar per hectare per year. It's not a huge amount, but for big ranch and big extensions, it can be a nice increase in income. And here we need to bear in mind that this without any additional cost, because we saw that with less nitrogen, with the same cost, we are getting the same revenue. It's only a matter of awareness. We can do it without having any additional cost for it. And this is this kind of initiative is taking it's taking it our take some step forward recently when the company nitorgen in the North America is starting a pilot in which they are offering farmers to join this pilot and reducing the emission of nitrous oxide emissions, also improving the capture of the CO2 inside the soil. And it can be done by adoption, what we call the minimal tillage, because tillage, and this, we are actually using less tractors in this cultivation, in this practice cultivation, and we have less CO2 emission due to this kind of, and beside of it, using of what we call enhanced nitrogen fertilizer, that it can be a slow release fertilizer, nitrogen inhibitors. And the idea in this pilot is to turn this regulation from a liability that farmers need to obey to an asset or opportunity for them. Another opportunity that can that we know from other segments too in on the food is that due to the higher awareness of the public to this kind of the footprint and the gas emission that actually today by far is the most problematic issue that the world, the globe are suffering today. We can mark the food as and create a niche of food in which premium food product that farmer will be preferred to use and to pay, even to pay more for consuming them, knowing that those products has less a low carbon footprint in their production. I'm just coming to the final two slides and here, okay, then let's say what the actual situation. You can see here on the left-hand side that today, the actual on 2018, there are those enhanced fertilizer that by different categories, I'm referring to controlled release, slow release, super coated, OREAs, and in this and the nitrification inhibitors, in total a sum amount of about 16 million tons. And this is presenting just a very small amount among the global world consumption of those of nitrogen. You can see here, it's on 2019, it was 253 million tons per year. Most of it is urea and followed by ammonium nitrate and ammonium sulfate. Then it's clearly that we are far by far from coming closer and there is a long way and space to do more in adopting those enhanced nitrogen fertilizer in order to mitigate the greenhouse, the global warming and all those harmful impacts. Just to summarize, last slide, we summarize that the CoteN Dual, as I mentioned before, it's a very good product or solution combining coated and uncoated material treated all kinds of sort of nitrogen and can enhance very much the nutrient use efficiency that's crucial in order to increase yield. That is also one of what we call the food security. This is can be also used to customize solution. And here the CoteN Dual can be blend into an NPK fertilizer as we are doing actually in the multi-crop agri line of Haifa. And clearly that using this CoteN Dual solution or combination, it clearly can help us to cope with the global warming and all these harmful effects. Okay, this is what we have for today. Thank you for listening. And now we'll have a few minutes for questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Gadi. Thank you, Gad. It was very interesting and good information. Before we start the questions session, I just want to say that this presentation and all other Haifa Academy webinars are on the YouTube channel of Haifa and the Haifa website. So if you missed something or want to see it again, you can go and see it there. Specific question we cannot answer because we don't have time, so I'll ask only the general question. One question is why to combine these two technologies together, the coated fertilizer and the inhibitors together?
Yes, okay. So I think I can answer, Gadi, with your permission. So we know that the CoteN mix is by far the best solution, practical solution. But when we are talking practically, we have to think also about other elements such as local regulation. and in some places, in most places, the CRF products are not recognized as part of the, officially as part of the solution, even though we can show and examine and go into depth and see how it is the solution, but nevertheless, it's not. So to combine it with inhibitor can be a solution in that form, that because in many times, in many places, at least half of the nitrogen need to be protected. And so one is secured and the other one is protected. This is my answer.
I would like to add to it, Gadi, that we have also a need of agronomical need, because as you know, all intensive crops, we need some portion of the nitrogen, what we call as a starter. And for this reason, we need to keep part of the nitrogen uncoated. The solution of coating all the material is not actually possible because of the crop requirement. And the CoteN Dual is giving us a solution that this portion that we are leaving in order to supply this amount of fertilizer initially can be protected and secure by using those inhibitors.
Okay, and just to show the effectiveness of this, the ratio between the regular volatilization from urea to this product, what is the...
So I think the main issue will be the application method, because if we will have it on the top dress, the CoteN mix, it's less effective, obviously. But then, I cannot argue that if it will be a mission or no, it might be. But if we apply it correctly into the soil, then there's no emission, hardly any leaching, nothing.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, but here you're referring to leaching, but you refer to leaching or to the emission?
Emission.
Emission. Okay, regarding emission from our trial that we did along the last 3 or 4 years, we've seen some cases losses of 20 or 30% from the broadcast applied urea. Again, in this case, it was mostly ammonia, not nitrous oxide. And for this, I think that we can reduce, and as we saw in one trial, we can reduce it dramatically by using this kind of combination.
Thank you. What external conditions affect the release of the nutrients, like weather?
From the CoteN part, in the CoteN Dual, the temperature is the main driver. Yeah, water we will have in a wood zone for sure. So then temperature is the one that changed the release rate. When it's the temperature goes up, then the release is faster. But if we're talking about the inhibitor, there we have less of a control, because then the pH can play a role. And then there's other effects that can change the effectiveness of the product and the lifetime. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I think our time is up. So thank you again, Gadi and Gad. It was very interesting. And I hope to see everybody in our next webinar. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Josh.